Hello, this is Bern, and on today's video, I'm going to show you how you can inspire men to value you and desire you more at the same time. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to another edition of BernMendez.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, and heart-centered women how you can attract the man you want and the relationship you crave, without the need for any gimmicks or manipulation or silly techniques. Now, if this is your first time here and this is the kind of insight you're seeking, then make sure to hit the subscribe button so you can be notified of more episodes as they come out. Now, wouldn't it be great if I could share with you something that not only increases your value in the eyes of men and the desire of men to connect with you, pursue you, feel like they want to spend time with you, but at the same time, that makes your life better. That makes your life more joyous. That makes your life more worth living. Because if that's the case, then if the byproduct of you having a better life also creates a connection you want, that's a triple win in my book. And that's what this whole thing's about. I want to share with you in this video what you can do to make your life awesome. And as a result of that, attract men who are willing to step up and be a life partner to you. Now, if you want to learn, before I get fully started, let me just share this with you. If you want to learn how to attract more quality men and you've been having trouble because you understand it intellectually, but you're not really embodying that result, then first link on the description of this video is a masterclass that I created for you. It's free. All you have to do is click that link, enter your name and email, and you'll see a page that looks like this, and you'll start watching that masterclass right away. Now, there's two principles that allow you to pull this off, inspire commitment, inspire desire, inspire value in men. One of them is called the magnet principle, and the other one is called the exclusion principle, and both work hand in hand. And I'll share with you why one is present, but the other one isn't, it doesn't really work. So what is the magnet principle? Imagine that you have a super strong magnet. That magnet is gonna pull into its energy field lots of different types of metals, right? When you attract that, and it's really hard for you to say, well, I only want to attract cobalt, but not iron. You're gonna attract lots of things if you're a strong magnet. That's what you can do if your magnet, your radiance, your passion is high. The exclusion principle means that you have to have filters and screens to make sure that you only let through those metals, so to speak, including metals are a metaphor for men, that are in sync with what you're seeking, and who are valuing what you have to offer. If you don't have both of these things, then it's gonna be really hard, because here's the thing. If you have high radiance, and that's what the magnet is a metaphor for, metaphor equals high radiance, your ability to let your light shine through unrestricted in many ways, happy, connected, fully alive, where it shows in the way you walk, in the way you look at human beings, in the way you speak, in the quality of actions you take, that is your radiance. That's the highest attractive force that you have to pull men into your orbit and allow them to want to spend time with you and value you. Now, if you have that, but you don't have a way of filtering them out means you need to have high standards. So the things you need to pull it off, I mean, so in, again, just to make this clear, magnet equals radiance, and exclusion means high standards. So you need to have the ability to let your shine through more unrestricted, but also the ability to say, this is what I can do and this is what I can't do. In order to pull this off, you have to step into what I call an abundant mentality. It's really hard for you to have high standards when in the back of your mind, you think, if I were to put my standards right now, if I were to share them, if I were to set a boundary, guys would not want to be with me. I don't have something valuable enough to offer that if I share what my standards are, they'll want to stick around. So when that's the belief that's behind you, what happens is you have high radiance, so you attract guys, but among the guys you attract are guys who just want to have a good time, who want to connect with you physically, maybe even emotionally a little bit, but have no intention of committing. And because you're not clear on what you have to say and how you have to set those boundaries, they waste your time. You connect with them physically, for example, you get really attached to them, and then when it's time for them to step up, they can't, so they break your heart. And then you rinse and repeat this process time and time again, and then you start believing that all men out there are this type of men. But it's not that all men out there are this type of men, it's that how you're doing things is allowing you to only have this experience. So there's nothing wrong with you. There might be something wrong with your approach. And not wrong as in good or bad, but something that's giving you the opposite result of what you want. So first thing you have to do is make sure that your radiance, your magnet, is active. And I'll share more of that in a second. Second thing you have to do is make sure that you have a good set of boundaries in place that allow only the guys who want something serious, who want to value you as a human being, to continue connecting with you, and those who don't have the ability or the will to go the distance, to stop. Because a problem that I've encountered on the opposite side of the spectrum is when women have high standards and they are clear on their boundaries, but the attractive force is not there. Imagine that. Imagine that you have high standards, you believe in yourself, but you're not really letting your shine through in a way that's attractive to men. It's like having an incredible sweater made out of wool that you put out for sale in the summer. No one wants that. It's valuable and it's great in the winter, but not in the summer. So that's why both need to be hand in hand. So how do you pull this off? Well, first I'll say why this is so important, why standards are so important. They are so important because men, all men, value more what they work hard to get. And by hard to get, I do not mean, and I underline this, playing hard to catch, because that's just a stupid game that won't get you anywhere. But hard to get means that you have a system in place for how to move forward and what things are necessary for you to feel safer and open at different kinds of levels. So when men value you because they're connecting with you and they're testing you, right? All men test women, all women test men, subconsciously. When men connect with you and they throw something at you, you haven't even met, and come over to my place, let's have dinner, and you say yes, I mean, maybe he has no bad intentions, but what's the likelihood that if you go to his place, things can get more intimate or he can be a little bit more relaxed in the way he presents himself to you? It's probably higher. So what happens when you say yes? Well, when you say yes, then you're opening the doors for you to have a really bad time or for the guy to be a little bit more touchy-feely than you want because you didn't set that boundary in place. So if he says something like that to you and your boundary is, you know what, I haven't met you yet, so I don't want to go to your place, but how about this? You give me another option. Then two things can happen. One, guys who want something serious will say, I recognize that you have high standards, and I recognize that there's a reason why you may not want to come to my place. That has nothing to do with me. It's just the thing to do. So I'm going to say yes and meet you somewhere else. Let's say a guy is more into himself, is more selfish, or just wants to have a good time, or just wants to have sex with you. He's going to do a little drama, tantrum on you. He's going to try to guilt you into going there. He's not going to want to do it. But guess what happens? If you set that boundary, you win. If he wants to step up, you win. If he wants to step down, you win. But you won't waste your time by doing something that in advance you know might get you into trouble. So all men value what they work to get, and all men find more value in themselves when they get something that didn't come easy. So what does that mean? Well, if in that test, a guy connects with you and says, hey, you want to come to my house? You've never met the guy. You don't know how safe it is. You say yes, and then the guy wants to kiss you, and you go for it, and the guy wants to have sex with you, and you say, well, I like him, so sure, let's do it. The guy didn't have to work hard at all to get this. So he's going to value it, most likely than not, as easy as it came. So it came easy. He can let go of it easily. There's less attachment. There's less emotional investment. That's why you want to make sure that as you grow your radiance, you also grow your ability to up your standards. If you want to increase your radiance, if the challenge you're finding yourself right now is, I'm not radiant enough, I'm not even creating that connection with guys, they're not seeing me, they're not asking me out, they're not wanting to pursue me, then the way you can increase your magnet is, I'll give you three simple things. One is movement. The quality of your movements will dictate the flow of your radiance. So if you're struggling with radiance, start moving more. Start dancing more, start exercising more, start breathing more fully, start unwinding that restriction that life and pain and bad experiences cause in human beings that make us be less expressive. So movement and expressiveness through movement is something that can help you to increase your radiance, where you don't have to be dancing in the streets, where if you just danced and you go walking, there's a different vibe in your step that takes place when that's the case. Second thing you can do to increase your magnet is pleasure, your connection to pleasure. What things are you connecting with that create pleasure in you, and how fully are you allowing that pleasure to flow through your body? And that includes anything from connection with yourself to anything that you do that allows that feeling of joy, touch, massage, movement, dancing, singing, watching things that are inspirational in nature, connection with great friends, laughter, all those things that are pleasurable, full joy. The last thing you can do is connect to things that make you feel inspired. What makes you feel inspired? What makes you feel like you're contributing? Whenever you connect to those things, again, you don't have to try hard to increase your radiance when you're doing the things that make the energy through your body, heart, and spirit shine by nature unrestricted. That makes your life better and it makes you more attractive. Now, what can you do in terms of, if that's working well, or if you're working on that already, to also increase the high standards? I'll give you some categories of standards you want to think for yourself. The first one is time for exclusivity. Some guys want to date you and they want to make sure you don't date anyone from the start. I don't recommend doing that. It's too risky for you. So it's going to take some time before you feel safe to be exclusive with a guy. Number two is sex. What are your standards for sex? Can you have sex with somebody before they're exclusive with you or not? I don't recommend it, but if you do it, then there's typically consequences as a result of that, including attachment to guys that seem great but are not great for you long term. Physical contact. How much physical contact do you experience early versus late? How much intimacy you have? How much vulnerability you share? There's people who say you should be an open book, and there's no need to be an open book if somebody's not safe enough to share everything about your life. There's something to be said about being vulnerable step by step versus sharing everything in the open and then recognizing this guy's unsafe for me to share these things with him. So the more you think about what are the things you need in respect, in sex, in physical contact, in level of conversation and intimacy, and you can clearly communicate to guys, here's when I feel safe doing this, here's what I can share right now, the better you will show your value and how you appreciate and love yourself to those men. And the men who are looking for something serious will think and feel, that's incredible. That's the type of woman I want to introduce to my mom and dad, versus that's the kind of woman that I can have fun with on a weekend and perhaps forget. You don't want that to be the case. I wish I could share with you things happen differently, but they don't. So it's better for you to act the way things are in the world than the way you wish things were. Hope this is helpful, useful, and insightful to you. If it is, and you want to learn how to go deeper, not intellectually, but from your heart, then hit the first link on the description of this video. And when you do that, you can enter your name and email and start watching my free masterclass right away. If you enjoy this video, please click like or thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel. When you hit the little bell, you'll make sure that YouTube shows you the videos, because you could be subscribed and not see my videos if you don't hit the little bell. So make sure to hit that if you really enjoy this content. And last but not least, if you've been working through on yourself, going to therapy, doing cleanses, consulting with the stars, and not the result that you want is not showing up for you, you're still not creating the connection you want with men, you might highly benefit from getting my insight and hand-holding through the process. Second link on the description of this video will allow you to apply to work with me, and if we're a fit, I can share with you how I can help you to get what you want in a fraction of the time. Thank you so much for allowing me into your heart, into your home, into your experience, and as always, I challenge you to live a full and conscious life.